Now, if you're watching this video, I'm guessing you're planning a trip to Thailand. You're ever so excited, but you have a few unanswered questions. I'm going to be talking all about backpacking Thailand for the first time. Now, obviously, Thailand is massive, but I'm going to be covering the destinations most popular to backpackers. So, without further ado, let's get started. I can't see this being a short video. Why go to Thailand? Thailand appeals to a wide variety of people for many reasons. It's a big country, but by far the most visited destination by backpackers is the island. I'm sure you all heard about the infamous full moon party, but if not, let me explain. It takes place once a month when the full moon is present, obviously, on the idyllic Haad Rin beach, which is on the far south of the Thai island of Koh Tao. It attracts over 30,000 partygoers every month, and the idea really is to get as drunk as you possibly can, dance the night away, pass out on the beach, wake up, sun's rising, and you start partying again. It's an ideal situation. Tips for the full moon and Koh Tao. Beware the buckets. They get you shit-faced. They are full of vile, cheap alcohol that you're going to get because everyone does, but dear God, be sure to watch them make it. Do not purchase pre-made buckets because there could be anything in there. Anything. Beware the shroom shake. I never actually went there, but there is a mushroom bar somewhere near the beach, and they are selling shroom shakes for worryingly affordable prices. I strongly recommend you don't even enter this bar because a lot of people die from these shakes, but for the love of God, if you do end up there, please just don't have one. It's not worth it. Don't stay near Haad Rin. Now, this is completely down to personal preference, but I would recommend staying about halfway up the island. If you stay in Haad Rin, it's impossible to escape the constant craziness. What I think a lot of people don't know or forget is that aside from all the parties, Koh Tao is actually a beautiful, quiet paradise island. I strongly recommend staying about halfway up near a town called Ban Thai. It's about a 20-minute taxi ride away from the party down at Haad Rin Beach. The taxis run 24/7, and whether you're staying 5 or 25 minutes away, the set price is always about 100 baht, which is about £2 one way, so you might as well stay in the nicer areas. Ride mopeds with caution. We got mopeds and found them extremely useful because the island is significantly large and it would be an absolute trek to walk everywhere. But again, just don't be an idiot. Okay, other islands. Koh Samui. Koh Samui is the largest tourist island in Thailand. It's good for partying and general island life. It is a common stopover for backpackers, but it wasn't particularly recommended to us, and the quality of partying and general island life is said to be better in Koh Tao anyway. Koh Tao. Koh Tao is a very small island situated north of Koh Tao. It is the best of all the islands for scuba diving, so if that's on your list, it's definitely a must. But if scuba diving isn't your thing, it's still an amazing island. It's great for snorkeling and amazing sunsets and stargazing. Koh Phi Phi. Koh Phi Phi, I strongly recommend. It's a tiny, tiny island where you can literally walk from one side to the other in about 15 minutes. There's no mopeds, there's no cars, it's completely pedestrianised with the occasional annoying bike. Don't get a bike. Amazing nightlife, amazing beaches, amazing snorkeling trips, and only a short boat ride away to Maya Bay, which is where everyone gets those amazing the beach pictures. And finally, Koh Lanta. Koh Lanta is the least known by backpackers of the Thai islands, but it is becoming increasingly popular. You won't find any crazy parties, but you will find amazing beaches and wondrous rainforests. It's the perfect place to fully relax after partying on all the other islands. And that's the islands. Well, all the islands easily accessible to backpackers anyway. So moving on to mainland, Bangkok. This is more than likely the city that you're going to fly into, and it's definitely worth a look around, but I suggest not staying for too long. Koh Samui Road is a must. The shopping is amazing, and the nightlife is 100% bizarre. Just bizarre. Bangkok is also an extremely good place to see temples if you're into that, but Bangkok is extremely busy and humid, so I would say that 2 days is long enough, but obviously completely down to personal. Okay, Northern Thailand. I strongly recommend going to Northern Thailand. Chiang Mai, Chiang Rai, and Pai are all great places for backpackers to visit. Great shopping markets, elephant and tiger sanctuaries, jungle trekking, cooking classes, bamboo rafting, basically what Thailand is all about, minus the beaches. And that's it for the places in Thailand. Obviously there's so many more, like Phuket and Krabi, but the places I've mentioned are by far the most popular destinations by Thailand. So we'll swiftly move on to transport and getting around. Being on a backpacker budget, you're obviously going to be searching for the cheapest option. Regarding shorter journeys, especially in Bangkok, always get a taxi over a tuk-tuk. I mean, get a tuk-tuk for the experience, but they rip you off big time. Always get a taxi and always justify with the driver before you leave that you're going to be paying by the meter. Again, otherwise you will be ripped off big time. With regards to the longer journeys, for example travelling from Bangkok to Chiang Mai or Bangkok to the islands, a popular option is the sleeper train. Expect to pay about £20 for a second class air conditioned bed. It is possible to get road buses which are cheaper and sometimes shorter, but obviously they are not half as comfortable. But all this is super easy to book. There are travel agents everywhere offering you all the different modes of transport available to get to pretty much anywhere you need. It is also possible to book internal flights, which are obviously much faster but less popular with the backpackers, because if you haven't booked far in advance, then they are significantly more expensive. Accommodation. It's always best to book your first night's accommodation in country in advance. I mean, it's best to book in advance anywhere you go, but being a backpacker, you never know when you're going to be arriving in the next place, so it's not always possible. And honestly, that is completely fine, because as soon as you arrive in a new place, a swarm of Thai hosts will just surround you, willing for you to stay with them, and they do offer good prices. If you can afford to get an air-conditioned place, I strongly recommend that you do, because even when you've got a fan, you sweat like a motherfucker. On the bright side, I did lose 2 stone from constant sweating, and obviously dorms are cheaper than private rooms, but if you're in a larger group, a private room might work out cheaper. You will have to do your maths, I'm afraid. I was in a 3 and most of the time we would just get a double room because, let's be honest, you spend most nights passed out on a beach anyway. In terms of price in the accommodation, non-air conditioned you can expect to pay about £3 to £6 a night, and air conditioned you should expect to pay about £7 upwards. Food! Obviously a predominantly Thai cuisine. Think rice, noodles, fried veg, curries. Street food is the cheapest option at about 40 baht per meal. But don't worry if you're not a fan, because every other restaurant literally sells a worldwide cuisine. Be prepared for 50-page menus in most places. It is just ridiculous. And you'll find yourself eating out every day anyway, because meals are on average about 100 baht, which is about £2. And I can't forget to mention the toasties that they sell at 7-Eleven. They're about 40 baht, and when you're drunk, they are just the most amazing food. Or if you're just really tight on a budget, you can just have it as a meal. Budgeting! As you probably already guessed, Thailand is extremely cheap. The currency is in baht, and currently, as of November 2013, the exchange rate is £1 to 52.48 baht. So just think, £1 is 50 baht, £2 is 100 baht, the maths is pretty easy. Now obviously daily budgets are going to vary vastly depending on the person, what you're doing, what your plans are. But I can tell you that I budgeted about £25 a night for both the North Thailand and the islands, including my travel. The islands are significantly more expensive, but there is arguably much more to spend your money on in the North, so it sort of balances out. The way I worked it out was, on average per day, was £4 for accommodation, £5 for food, £2 for travel, and £10 for activities or shopping, and then you're able to afford the longer journeys every few days. So it accounts for the fact that while some days you're spending nothing sunbathing on the beach, while some will be more expensive days, perhaps frolicking with elephants. Still with me? So basically for a month in Thailand, I would budget £750. Okay, communication. In my opinion, a phone is really not necessary. As long as you have a device that connects to Wi-Fi, there is free Wi-Fi in almost every restaurant, complex, and hostel that is in Thailand, so you're absolutely fine when it comes to that. Can I travel by myself? Of course you can! You will find so many other like-minded backpackers in all the hostels that it's almost impossible not to make friends. If you're worried, just be open. Ask where people are going that day. Ask if you can join them. Visas. If you are a UK citizen, it is free for the first month in Thailand. No visa required. If you intend to stay longer for free, you have to leave the country and then come back in. However, if you are travelling across land back into the country, you're only allowed in for 14 days. But if you fly back into the country, you're allowed in for a further 30 days. No, I have no idea how that works, but whatever you do, don't overstay how long you're allowed, because you will end up paying an extortionate amount of money, or you will end up in a Thai jail, and I can guarantee you that will not be fun. It is possible to buy a visa which allows you to stay longer, but obviously you have to work that out in advance. What is the climate like? It is always hot in Thailand. The rainy season is July to October, so maybe don't go there. We went in March and it was perfect. Beautiful sun every day. And that's it. Sorry the lighting went a bit crazy. It got darker much faster than I anticipated outside, so a few lights had to be switched on. I will leave all useful links and recommendations in the description box below. I really hope this video helped, and if you have any other specific questions, please do feel free to ask. And my next video will be on Laos. Bye!